Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 2016 annual Shonen All-Star Tournament. Yes, this is the annual 2016 All-Star Tournament. Sorry it took so long. Yes, the deadline was at 1:20, and now it is 1:24. So it is now Sunday, which is probably where I'm doing this right now. So when this video goes up, make sure to watch it, give it a like, subscribe, and also tell me who you guys want in the next year tournament. Because I will be posting this every single year. This will be every year an annual tournament, or it might be a monthly tournament. I can't decide yet. It might be a monthly tournament just because I like to do tournaments a lot. But it might be a monthly one, but I don't know just yet. But anyways, if you guys want your characters to be in the next tournament, please let me know in the comments, or let me know on Anime Amino or on Twitter, which will all be in the link in the description below. So anyways, I got the bracket right here. You guys should be seeing it on the screen right now. And the lineup is pretty good. Some of these characters I got from you guys on Anime Amino, and some of the characters on Anime Amino that I got from you guys are not in the game, which I'm very sad about, and I'm sorry about that. Natsu's not in the game. Mermelon is not in the game from Hunter x Hunter. The Beazel guy or the Bamboo guy from Toriko is not in the game. I'm very sorry about that. Hopefully they'll update this game and we'll get more characters, but other than that, let's just start this tournament. So going with the preliminaries, or going for the first round, first matches of the day, because we'll be posting every match every day. So when you move on to the next match, it'll be the next day, next day. But let's move on to the first matchup of the day. We're going to have, I can never pronounce her name. And I forgot to tell you guys that we're not doing any support characters, because I just found that out. Like, why put support characters? You know, we just have to have them fight one-on-one. So we're going to have we're going to put her as a computer. And she's going to be going up against Sasuke. Now, this was kind of a lineup I did not think to put, because I actually did this random. I actually randomized these names, and that's what I got. So she's going to go up against Sasuke, and this fight should be really good. Alright, the arena, we're going to do random, and 30 second time limit. It's like they know that I'm doing a tournament, so they put me at the Dark Tournament Stadium. I said that wrong, don't really care. Both to center. Begin. Here goes Sasuke rushing in for the attack, but no. Madoka rushing Sasuke. Madoka getting the kill. There goes Madoka. Madoka is doing some serious damage to Sasuke right now. Sasuke's health is really low at this moment, but Sasuke has three chances to get her health as low as she does. What? She's in her awakening mode. I'm just gonna call it awakening mode, or her burst mode. Sasuke still has a chance to win this, because this round is not over yet. He has three chances to win this. And there goes Sasuke, getting the Susanoo arm. And Madoka is taking her chances and doing range attacks. Sasuke with his sword slicing and dicing Madoka, and she misses. Sasuke and Madoka are the first matches of the night, so some of these matches may be a little bit boring due to the fact that it's their first matches of the night. But also, we have to do the next matches the next day. So some of the matches might get a little bit more interesting as they go along. And Sasuke does the fireball jutsu. Madoka just stands there and takes it. And she keeps doing range attacks. Will that kill off Sasuke? Remember, there's a time limit. There's a 300 time limit. And also, Sasuke gets three chances to take down Madoka. Sasuke doing Nidori Nesh, but does not take effect. And there goes Madoka with that huge leg drop, knocking out Sasuke. Sasuke's back in the playing field. His health is at full, but will Madoka be able to take him out? No, Sasuke with the Anamastaru. I forgot how to say it. Amastaru. I'm just going to call it the Mangekyo Sharingan, because that's technically what he has, what he's doing. She's going into awakening mode again. There she goes, back into awakening mode. That seems to be the only way she can beat Sasuke. But every time she goes into it, she just spams. That's technically what I might see on Storm 4. It's just spamming a lot. It's going to be like boring matches on Storm 4 because people just want to spam a lot. But back to the gameplay in hand. Sasuke, another fireball jutsu, but will it hit? Yes, it does, but it takes no damage. As she keeps her distance. Oh, what a huge booty drop. Butt drop. Knocks Sasuke up into the air, but does not take the chance. And now Sasuke with the sword, and then it does the Chidori. Oh, she tries to do the gravity words. Now Sasuke with another Chidori, but no, does not take effect. Chidori Ness does not take effect either. Sasuke's moves are not doing a bit of damage to Madoka. Remember, Sasuke is still on time limit, so he has to try to get her down as fast as he can. At least score 1 point on her. If Sasuke just hits her once, she is done. Oh, what a block. She ran right into the fireball jutsu, but then blocked it at the last minute. Sasuke with the sword knocks her down. But now Sasuke has 85 seconds left in order to take her down for good, in order to get those 3 kills. This might be a draw. I don't really know what this game goes by due to draws. It might go by the person who has the less health. And Madoka just keeps doing gravity words. And now with those rapid punches, blasts back Sasuke with that huge force palm. And now rapid punches. Oh my gosh, look at those rapid moves that Madoka has. Going into victory burst. Should probably change their bursts up, but I don't know. I didn't feel like doing that. Here goes Sasuke with another fireball jutsu. But no, it's canceled out. There he goes. Oh my gosh. Sasuke tries to do Chidori Nez, but Madoka gets him with her ultimate attack. Sasuke is way out of bounds. Not way out of bounds. Sasuke is way out of the range here. But no, still hits her with the fireball jutsu. Sasuke has 30 seconds left. The countdown is really going bad for Sasuke in his favor. Sasuke avoids the gravity words, hits her with the Shonen, hits her with the Susanoo arm, but then Madoka still gets the upper advantage. Madoka stands there like a boss, taking the fireball jutsu. Sasuke has 5 seconds left to at least put some damage on her.
All right, guys, the next matchup of the night is Goku versus Kenshin. Left.
This fight should be a good one because Kenshin, we all know, is a fantastic swordsman, and we all know
with
Goku
2 points
is fantastic.
To Sasuke. Sasuke has won.
I don't want to complete that sentence,
Sasuke,
but Goku is fantastic with his abilities. So, Goku's an excellent brawler.
God.
He has been Super Saiyan, Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan God,
on to the next
Saiyan, which I think they should shorten the name. But hopefully Kenshin will be able to get one over on Goku. But Goku, no, out of the gate with the Kamehameha. Now here goes Kenshin rushing to Goku, but Goku jumps over Kenshin, luckily knocks him out of the air, back to the ground. Goku tries to hit him with the meteor burst, but does not complete the combo. Here goes Kenshin. Oh my. Kenshin with an ultimate attack to Goku. This will be a very disappointing match if Goku would lose this match to Kenshin. Oh my gosh, Kenshin with that huge combo. Kenshin is hitting Goku while he's down. That's the best thing you can do in this tournament. Hit your opponent while he's down. Here goes Goku, tries to do an attack, but misses. Goku now on the offensive. Goku with the meteor burst and completes the combo. Goku trying to go Super Saiyan here, looks like. And Kenshin trying to do the same, but no, Goku doesn't completely do it. And then here goes Goku with the Kamehameha, hits him while he's down. Here goes Kenshin all fired up. Oh my gosh, Goku blocks a sword attack and then just kicks him down. Goku blocks a sword attack and just kicks Kenshin down. Here goes Kenshin, tries to do another one, but no, misses. Goku with the meteor burst lands it, and now he's taking it to Kenshin. Oh my gosh, Goku is just wrecking the whole arena with his attacks. Would Goku be able to hit his meteor? Would Goku be able to hit his victory burst? That is the question here.
And then there goes Goku again.
Goku hitting the friendship burst or the victory burst. Here we go. There goes Goku flying over to Kenshin. Kenshin should have backed away from Goku because now Goku has his victory burst, but seems like Goku's not going to use it. Seems like Goku is saying that Kenshin isn't worth the spirit bomb, but it looks like Goku's going to have to do it at some point, but he already lost it. Goku is now knocked down. It is now one versus one. It is now one. What the heck? Is now 1 point against 1 point. Kenshin has one and Goku has one. But who will be that one person to get that final point? Remember, they're still on a time limit. They still have 146 seconds left. This match may be faster than the Madoka versus Sasuke fight. Than the Madoka versus Sasuke fight, excuse me. And now Kenshin is down yet again. Goku might be able to win this if he gets one more attack on Kenshin. Goku's very close to hitting his victory burst, but no, it looks like Kenshin's going to take that victory burst away from him. Remember, Kenshin has not had a victory burst yet, but Goku has had one already. Will Goku be charging up to Super Saiyan? No, Goku charges up for the Kamehameha, but Kenshin just takes it. Kenshin stands there, takes it, and is still on his feet. Now Kenshin going on the offensive to Goku. All Kenshin needs to do is score one more point against Goku, and it could be a tie. I don't know what Kenshin's trying to do now. Kenshin's probably trying to buy time here, but buying time is not in Kenshin's favor. Goku has not yet gotten down after Kenshin scored his first point. And now Goku with the Kamehameha blasts Kenshin off this tournament. I think it's kind of bad they don't have the World Tournament from Dragon Ball Z in here, but this tournament is actually really good as well. And now Goku. Oh my gosh, Goku with those awesome combos there. Now Kenshin spamming the move over and over again. Again, another thing we might see in Storm 4. Kenshin only has 30 seconds left to attack Goku with everything he's got, but Goku, there it goes, might get the win. Goku's taunting Kenshin. Two seconds left. But no, Goku wins it. But Kenshin lands the last hit. Goku wins the fight. Goku wins the fight, ladies and gentlemen. Goku is your winner. On to the next round. Matchup is Gon versus Oga and Baby Eel. Everybody's favorite anime character, Gon, going up against somebody's favorite character, Baby Eel and Oga. All right, scored 130 JP. Don't care about that. Here he goes. Looks like Gon's already going into Nen with the Jai Jai King Palm or the Jai Jai King Rock. Oh no, that's paper. Jai Jai King Paper. Now, I forgot what that one's called. Here goes Gon going on the offensive right now. Looks like Oga and Baby Eel's trying to gain some distance for some reason. This might be another ranged fight. Gon's going for the Jaja King Palm again, or Jaja King Paper. I keep saying Jaja King Palm. Jaja King Paper. Looks like Gon powered down for some reason. Gon, Jaja King Scissors. Gon just keeps trying to do it. I don't know why Gon just won't fight him. There goes Gon with his fishing pole. Gon pulls the fishing pole out of nowhere. Now they're both kicking cement here. Baby Eel with that huge fire blast takes out Gon, but doesn't take him out fully. Gon could be the winner of this matchup if he just does a little bit more of attacking to Baby Eel and Oga. Gon tries to go for another Jaja King, but doesn't land it. Or doesn't finish the combo, at least. Now there goes Gon attacking Oga and Baby Eel. These two are doing some ranged attacks for some reason. These two are not going close to each other. This fight may be over as soon as it gets started, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I don't know what they're doing. That's why I'm being quiet. I don't know what they're doing. What are you guys doing? Okay, now we got Gon going on the offensive, taking out Oga. Now, Gon has 1 point. All Gon has to do is probably run away from Oga and keep that 1 point so he doesn't get down. But I don't think Gon rolls that way. Gon is going to go right to Oga with that Jaja King paper. Now, Gon going into Nen. If Gon gets his victory burst, he could win it. Oga tries to do a fire burst to the ground under Gon or above Gon, but Gon ran away. Now Gon going on the offensive right now. Oga, now those rapid punches, takes out Gon with those explosive punches there. Now here goes Gon with his victory burst, does a Jaja King Palm, Jaja King Rock, gosh darn it. Now here goes Gon, he's in his ultimate, he's in his awakening state, but he's not using his ultimate attack for some reason. Maybe Gon's saving it up, maybe Gon doesn't need it. Maybe Gon does not need his ultimate attack. This is why he's not using it. Maybe Gon's saying that he can beat this guy by himself without any help. Or without using his ultimate. Gon can beat Oga if he just attacks him with the Jaja King paper. There goes Gon in his awakening state. Gon might get down here. Gon is now knocked out. It took a long time for Gon to get knocked out, but now Oga has at least 30 seconds to at least get another point on Gon. But it doesn't look like Oga's gonna have the right time to do so. Gon getting knocked out there. But Gon gets right back up, hitting the Jaja King paper, but misses it. They're both kicking the air now. And now Gon gets that one final point against Oga. The time might be over. Oga, you have no more time to do it unless you hit a victory burst, but you do not have time to do so. This fight is over. Ladies and gentlemen, Gon is your winner. If you guys thought Baby Eel was gonna win this, then you guys probably suck. If you guys thought Gon was gonna win this, then you guys are awesome. Now, if you guys want to bet on who might win the finals or who might be in the finals, please place your bets in the comment section below. And I will award you. No, I won't. I won't do that. But anyway, just bet on who you guys want. Who you guys might win this in the finals. So on to the next round. Toriko Sensei is Kuro Sensei versus Tasuna. Now, I just got through watching Assassination Classroom. It is a really good anime. I really love it. It's really funny. Kuro Sensei is a really funny guy in it. He can get serious at times, but other times he's really funny. I like how the class tries to kill him at any moment they get, but they cannot land a hit at all. They got all these weapons, all these guns. They got so much help from so many people. Some people like attack the class because they want the money for themselves, but again, the anime is really great. Can't wait to come out with the next episode. But anyways, here goes Tasuna. Tasuna is taking out Kuro. Kuro with his Mach speed. Mach speed. He should be able to deflect Tasuna's skills. Oh my. Launches Tasuna up into the air. Looks like Kuro Sensei might win this, like, nonetheless. Because all Tasuna has been able to do is get Kuro Sensei's health down to a little bit. Kuro Sensei is dodging every attack that Tasuna has. But no, does not dodge that one. Looks like Tasuna is trying his very best to take out Kuro Sensei. But his best is not enough in this tournament. Tasuna is trying his best with these combinations, with these air combinations. He's really trying his best here. Looks like Kuro Sensei is kind of embarrassed right now. And now there, Kuro Sensei gets down. Kuro Sensei is now down. That's less than what I can say about the class, about the people in his classroom who can barely get him, to die. I kind of want to know if they're going to actually try to kill him in the end, or if they just want to keep him as their teacher. Because they said that he might destroy, they said that he will destroy the Earth in March, but you guys don't know if he'll have a change of heart by that time or not. So that's what I want to know. Will he have a change of heart, or will he still be destroying the world, and will they still have to kill him? And here goes Tasuna with his victory burst. Tasuna's the second person to actually do his victory burst. But no, misses it entirely. Because of Kuro Sensei in the air. Because of Kuro Sensei in the air, Tasuna was not able to land his victory burst. I think Tasuna should have waited to at least perform it. Kuro Sensei has almost defeated Tasuna, but he needs to get that final attack on him. He needs to get at least that one point. Looks like Tasuna is trying everything he can to take down Kuro Sensei. Maybe Tasuna's heard about Kuro Sensei's prize money, or Kuro Sensei's money over his head, and now Tasuna is trying to get that money for himself. And no, Tasuna is now down. Like, Tasuna's now on the offensive right now. Doing X Gloves Air. X Burst Air. I mean, I forgot what that's called. I need to watch Hunter x Hunter. I need to watch Hitman Reborn again. And now Kuro Sensei now has his victory burst. Will Kuro Sensei do it right then and there, or will he save it up? Will he not use it at all? Looks like Kuro Sensei is not even going to try to use his victory burst. Kuro Sensei does have the chance to use it, but he looks like he's not going to. But Coral Sensei doesn't need to use his victory burst. Is that Coral Sensei doesn't want to use it either? You know, I've never seen Coral Sensei's victory burst either, so I don't really know what his victory burst is. I probably need to play as Coral Sensei after this, but. Coral Sensei flying into a wall for some reason. That should have gave Tasuna his chance to take down Coral Sensei, and it looks like it did. Tasuna is now got 2-1 over Coral Sensei. He has 5 seconds left to take down Tasuna. That doesn't look like it's going to be enough time. Tasuna is your winner. I'm actually kind of disappointed. I thought Coral Sensei was actually going to win it, but Tasuna is your winner right here in this matchup. Let's move on to the next matchup of the day. Luffy versus Naruto. This is a fight I did not think I would get randomized, but apparently it was a fight that obviously J-Stars wanted to see. So I randomized everything and I got Luffy versus Naruto. Don't know how this happened, but this should be a really good fight nonetheless. This should be a better fight than Sasuke versus Madoka. That fight was just horrible. Naruto already going into his Sage mode. Cannot land a hit against Luffy. Luffy, oh my gosh. Luffy's doing everything he can to take down Naruto. Seems like these two has had a conflict in the past that Luffy doesn't want to lose against him. Naruto's trying to land a hit but cannot land at least one. Luffy is just on the offensive the whole round. Will Naruto be able to at least get Luffy down to at least half health? Like Naruto is finally trying to go into the offensive. Oh my! Luffy knocks Naruto into a pillar. That's the first time we've ever seen that in J-Stars, in the J-Stars tournament. Naruto with the Rasengan trying to gain some space here, but now going back on the offensive to Luffy. Naruto again trying to gain some space here. Don't know what Naruto's trying to do here. And now Naruto with that huge kick knocking out Luffy, or knocking down Luffy at least. Naruto charged up, and now we don't know what Naruto's trying to do now. Luffy with that Gomu Gomu no Gatling, or Foot Gatling. Luffy is just on the huge offensive right here, doing Gomu Gomu no Gatling. It seems like in the battle between Naruto versus Luffy, it seems like the winner will be most likely Luffy if you put them together. Oh, not here. Looks like Naruto tried to hit something there. Naruto finally hit it. Don't know what that was, though, that he was trying to hit. Now he tries to hit the Rasengan while Luffy was on the ground. Luffy! Gomu Gomu no second gear Gatling. Or Gomu Gomu no jet Gatling. Blah. Naruto got knocked down. Luffy has 1 point. Naruto goes back into Sage mode, taking out Luffy. But will Naruto be able to at least take him out? Will Naruto be able to at least get that 1 point against Luffy? This might be the only matchup where the other opposing team does not get a point at all. Luffy going in the second gear. Naruto in Sage mode. Luffy in second gear. Who's going to win this matchup? Sage mode in second gear. Luffy with the Gomu Gomu no rifle. Jet rifle. Naruto. Rasen Shuriken misses entirely. Naruto's having a bad day here against Luffy. But now Naruto looks like he's trying to catch up at least. Remember, Naruto still needs to get that 1 point against Luffy. If Naruto can get that 1 point, he'll be in the clear. But looks like Luffy's not going to give Naruto the time of day here. Tries to do the jet bazooka, but does not land it. Naruto's using everything at his disposal. Shadow clones, Rasengan, Rasengan Shuriken, Sage mode. Naruto's trying to use everything in his disposal. Trying to use everything in his arsenal here to take out Luffy. But looks like Luffy is not having any of it. Luffy going into his victory burst. Here goes Luffy with his victory burst and ultimate. Luffy is the third person who's using his ultimate in this tournament. And it's actually hitting it. Naruto's health is way low right now. I'm actually really sorry for Naruto, but this is what Naruto gets for those stupid fillers. Naruto gets the crappy out of him with Luffy. But I don't blame Naruto for their fillers. I blame Studio Parrot. Now Luffy got 2 points over Naruto. Naruto has no points at all. Naruto can still score a few points. He has 74 seconds left to at least score 1 point against Luffy. Here goes Rasen Shuriken. Luffy tries to run out of the way. Luffy gets hit. Luffy couldn't run out of the way in time, but Luffy is trying to make Naruto pay for that. Naruto still has no points. Luffy has 2. This is a very sad match to watch. Naruto is one of my favorite characters in all the animes, but seeing Naruto with no points while Luffy has 2 is very sad to me. Luffy, with the Gomu Gomu no, all Naruto had to do was hit him with the Rasengan Shuriken. All Naruto had to do was hit him with the Rasen Shuriken one more time, and he could have had Luffy knocked out. Naruto's in Sage. Luffy's in second gear. This went bad last time when Naruto did this. All Naruto needs to do is just land one more attack on Luffy, and it'll be over. Here we go. And now Luffy's down. Naruto has 1 point. Towards the ending of the fight, Naruto at least scored 1 point, but in the end, Luffy is your winner. This was a very sad fight to watch. Naruto versus Luffy. This was also a very fast-paced match to watch, at least, as well. Luffy tries to hit that final attack, but does not get it. But again, in the end, Luffy is your winner. This was the fight that I did not think that Luffy was going to win. But seeing Luffy with the Gomu Gomu no Mi fruit, apparently he won it. Apparently he won the fight. So anyways, let's continue on to the next fight. If you guys betted on Naruto winning this fight, I'm very sorry that you guys saw something that's really bad. This is horrible. Anyways, let's get on to the next fight. Kaylee versus Ichigo. This can either be a squash or it can be a fair fight depending on how you look at it. Aureli is a little android girl who's from the What If Saga in Dragon Ball Z or in Dragon Ball. And Ichigo is from Bleach. He is a very fantastic swordsman as well, so he should be able to at least score a few hits on Aureli. This can either be a squash or a fair fight depending on how you look at it. I'm looking at it as a fair fight. Looks like Ichigo is launching attacks from the range. Aureli scores the first hit on Ichigo. And now Ichigo, now going on the offensive. Aureli only was allowed to hit one hit on Ichigo. Now it looks like Ichigo is taking the offensive, but no, Aureli with that huge sonic wave blast mouth thing. Ichigo is for sure losing to Aureli right now, which is very sad on my part. I did not think this was going to happen. Now Ichigo is just spamming. Aureli's just jumping over Ichigo every chance she gets. Ichigo got tired of it and just launched her away. Looks like Ichigo is trying to charge up his attack. Oh, Ichigo has on the mask. This just turned into Tokyo Ghoul real fast. Aureli's blocking every attack that Ichigo's throwing at her. It's like Ichigo is trying very hard to take down Aureli. But Aureli's not going down without a fight, it looks like. She keeps taunting, it looks like. She keeps taunting Ichigo with that poop stick. All Ichigo did was spam Aureli, and that got her to go down. Oh my god, Ichigo Looks like that's the only attack in Ichigo's arsenal that he can do is that one attack. That's all he does. So you know what? I'm not even gonna commentate this match. This match is just like a spam. This match is just a spam, I promise you. Oh, it looks like Ichigo's doing something different. Never mind. As soon as I say I'm not gonna commentate this match because it's just spam, Ichigo's doing something different. Ichigo's doing something different, it looks like. Now he's getting some... Okay, never mind. I'm not gonna commentate this match. I'll see you guys later. Isn't a disappointment. Next matchup is Momotaro versus Roitsu is his name, I think. I don't care. Now this match can either be a fair fight or a squash, depending on what you guys think. I think it's going to be a squash. I think this match is going to be a squash. It's going to be another squash, just like the Naruto versus Luffy fight. This match is going to be another squash. Oh no! Looks like Roitsu is scoring a few attacks on Momotaro. Alright. Momotaro is attacking the stadium wall. Okay, I don't know what's going on here. Wow, looks like Roitsu is actually putting a few hits on Momotaro. This match could be a squash. This match could be a squash with Roitsu. It might not even be a fair fight. Look at this. Roitsu has like all these toys and everything at his disposal. But yet, Momotaro has a sword. Blocks it. Blocks the bomb with the sword. Roitsu has this helicopter that can shoot bullets at you. But Momotaro blocks it. Roitsu puts down his magazine, hits him with it. Now Roitsu is like on the offensive right now. Momotaro is just losing to Roitsu right now. Roitsu's health is not even as low as Momotaro's right now. I feel I'm embarrassed for Momotaro. I mean, Momotaro, you're losing to a guy who doesn't even have any special abilities, who doesn't have any powers whatsoever. That should be really embarrassing right now. Momotaro might lose this fight. This may be a fair fight. Momotaro and Roitsu is charging up. Roitsu's already charged up. Roitsu's on the offensive, just taking out Momotaro, taking out the Fantastic Swordsman. Oh, what an attack. I'm going to just call that the sword drill. Momotaro, or Roitsu bringing out the blade. Roitsu bringing out the blade. I wonder if anybody had just played Beyblades with this guy. Oh, I thought the match was over. I heard the music stop. Looks like Roitsu was the one to get knocked out first. I thought it would be Momotaro. But Momotaro has the first point of the day. This is surprisingly a fair fight. Oh my gosh, uses his headband as a sword there. Now Momotaro with the victory burst. Roitsu launches a rocket in the air. Momotaro's hiding behind a rock now for some reason. Momotaro, you have an ultimate attack. Why aren't you using it? See, some of these J-Star people don't use their ultimates. I don't know why. Is that him yelling? Why is he yelling like that? I thought that was Roitsu. That is him. I thought that was Roitsu. No, that is him. No, that's him. That's him. What? Why is he yelling like that when he charges? What the heck? How is that a thing? How is that a thing? Is that actually how he sounds when he charges up? He has like a little kid voice. He has like a very deep voice when he talks normally, but like when he charges up, his voice gets really high. Anyways, Roitsu could be on the urge to defeat right now. Roitsu with his ultimate attack. We all know what Roitsu's ultimate attack is, guys. Remember that. Roitsu's ultimate attack is his boss yelling at him. Out with the blade. Roitsu only has 6 seconds to at least land a hit. Or to at least get him knocked out again. This could be a tie. This is a total tie. But Momotaro is your winner due to the fact that Roitsu's health was lower than his. This was a total fair fight. I thought it was going to be a squash, but it was a fair fight nonetheless. So That surprised me. So, on to the next fight. Matchup of the night is going to be Saiki versus Togaru. This could be a fair fight due to my knowledge. I don't know what Saiki's actually moves or abilities are, but I do know what Toguru's abilities are. Toguru's abilities are very awesome. If you guys have not seen Yu Yu Hakusho yet, you guys really should. It's a very awesome show. I really like it a lot. I should actually rewatch it just because I like the show, but looks like Toguru's abilities is to teleport people. He's not really doing much damage to Toguru right now. Or Saiki's not really doing much damage to Toguru right now. But there he goes. Toguru's health is fading right now because of that attack that Psyche has. Looks like Psyche's abilities is to use electricity. Now Toguru, becoming the Broly that he is, becoming the Broly of J-Star's Battle Tournament. Here goes Psyche, charging up for something here. But looks like Toguru is not going to give him the slightest chance. You could say Toguru is the Elfman of J-Stars. If you guys don't know about Fairy Tail, then you guys won't get that joke. You guys won't get that joke if you guys haven't watched Fairy Tail yet. Looks like Toguru is finally starting to get Psyche's health down a little bit. Hopefully this isn't another ranged fight. Toguru is being electrocuted right now, launched up into the air. Looks like Psyche's taking his time with Toguru. Psyche's taking his time with Toguru, teleporting him everywhere, hitting him with electricity. Now with that huge combo right there, that was amazing by Psyche. I should start playing with him online. Like, I'll be getting a lot of rage from people. Hitting him with these electrified rocks, it looks like. Looks like these actually do something. And now knocks out Toguru with that one last rock around his body. Psyche now has 1 point. Toguru is enraged right now. I said Toguru? Is that his name Toguru? No, it's two. It's true. Tugo? Toguro? I think his name's Toguro. I'm gonna just call him Toguro. Toguro? I keep calling him Toguru for some reason. It's Toguro. Keep calling him Toguru for some reason. See, I forgot like so much about Hunter. Not Hunter, sorry. I forgot so much about Yu Yu Hakusho that I forgot this dude's name. Psyche tries to hit him with electricity, but Toguro. Toguro's on the offensive right now, charging up. I can probably see why they think that, Bleach was kind of like a ripoff of Yu Yu Hakusho, but still, Bleach was actually a good show to me. But anyways, Toguro launching Psyche. Psyche has his ultimate, but he's not using it for some reason. Most of these people on this tournament, or in this tournament, does not use their ultimates. Maybe because they don't really need it for these matches. Psyche's about to go down here. The whole tournament ring is obliterated. There's no more ring in this tournament for them to stand on. It is now the hardest ground. This is the final fight, and this could be, and this is the most destructive fight yet. As he's charging up for something, but he didn't charge up all the way. He runs right into Toguro's attack. Now Toguro finally gets him down, gets 1 point on that scoreboard. It is now a tie. We got 1-on-1. Psyche's trying his hardest to take down Toguru. Or Toguro. I keep saying Toguru. Frick me. Oh my. With a huge punch to Psyche now. Looks like that's the only attack that can take down Toguro here. I should really watch this dude's anime. Not his, but the other guy's. I should really watch his anime. His anime looks actually really, really appealing. Looks really trusting. Now there we go. We have our winner here. It is Psyche. He is the winner of this matchup. He's actually a really good fighter. I did not think he was going to be this good of a fight too. Toguru, whatever you guys want to call him, I don't really care. But anyways, This was the final matchup of the day. We'll be moving on to the semifinal, not the semifinal, but we're moving on to the next rounds of the day tomorrow. Hope you guys did like this. Please like, comment, and subscribe below for more. If you guys, again, want your characters to be in the next Shonen All-Star Tournament, next month probably, then please put your, or next year, I might do it next year, but anyways, if you guys want your characters to be in the next Shonen Tournament, please put your characters' names in the comment section below, and I'll take a snapshot of those comments, and I'll put them on my, I'll put them in one of my folders. I forgot what folder I have, I keep you guys' comments in, but anyways, I'll also be doing a tournament on Storm 4, so make sure if you guys want to play with me on Storm 4, my PSN is in the description below, my PS4 PSN is in the description below, and also make sure to add me on PSN if you guys really want to, and also make sure to tell me if you guys want to be in my tournament, because I'll be live streaming the tournament once the Storm game comes out. I'll be live streaming the tournament. There'll be two live streams, one will be Storm mode and one will be the tournaments, so I would love for you guys to be in it, and yeah, my name is obviously SpiderXAnime, and I will see you guys later.